Namaste India, I'm Deepali Phadnis, director of Mrs. India Pageants, and today we have three gorgeous ladies who have won Mrs. India 2018, and we are going to have a little chat over coffee, and we're going to know more about their journey, you know, their journey so far. They have reached here, that hardships they have gone through, the rewards they have received, and you know, their journey from state level pageant to national, and now they're going ahead for the international pageants. So welcome, queens.
Thank you.
Welcome home. You know, Mrs. India, we call Mrs. India as a family, and every time we meet, it's a coming home. So we'll start with Radhika.
Yes.
So Radhika, how do you feel? You know, our first time I met you in Mrs. India Delhi.
Yes, ma'am.
And from there to here, how do you feel? How was your journey?
Oh, it's been quite evolving. Mm-hmm. When I had come for Mrs. Delhi, that mm-hmm. time, I mean, like, I was absolutely clueless. Uh-huh. And not so confident, I would say. And I didn't even know what the pageant holds for me. But after winning runner-up there, mm-hmm. It gave me some boost, and I got a little more confident. And then after winning Mrs. India, it was like fantastic. I was feeling at the top of the world.
So, you know, in the starting, when you said that, you know, I was not sure. So did you feel that, you know, something is setting back you, or there's some reason for you to, you know, before stepping out, because it's a decision, right?
It was a decision, It was a big decision.
Yes.
Because my daughter had just given her 12 boards, mm-hmm. and it was time for her admissions.
Correct.
So, I mean, I was very confused because what to do.
Yeah.
In fact, you know, when I was even like contemplating whether to go ahead with this or not, mm-hmm. I was feeling very guilty. But then my daughter gave me a kind of support. She said that you go ahead.
So it's basically your daughter who pushed that you
yes,
have to go ahead.
I would say so. Yes.
So it's a princess, like queen's daughter, right? So Vaishnavi, you know, when I saw Vaishnavi for the first time at Mrs. India Karnataka, she was a different person. And now the Vaishnavi who is sitting here is altogether a different person. So
definitely.
Vaishnavi, how the difference and...
Definitely, it's been an evolving process for me personally, because I was not even aware of this pageant and how it, mm-hmm. you know, how to present yourself or anything.
Yeah.
Now, from Karnataka pageant to now, if you see, I have definitely evolved in a better way. And with this crown, mm-hmm. it comes there comes a responsibility to
yes.
do more. You know, it's not just about a gown or a crown. You need to do more, and you know, there's much more responsibility handed out to you. So I feel this platform is a wonderful platform, and you should make use of this platform to do good for others, and you know, to
yeah.
project your intentions and manifest in a beautiful way.
Sometimes do you feel that, you know, being under pressure, you know, to look always good, to always perform better, because once you get a crown on your head, you know, it's just not a crown, it's a weight on your head weight, you know, it's not the head weight of a pride, of the responsibility. So do you feel that you are under pressure to perform all the time?
Definitely,
you know?
Definitely, because people are looking at us as role models.
Yes.
And I would like to say something today, because this is not just about makeup or just presenting yourself.
Correct. Yes.
That way.
Yeah.
It is way beyond that, you
yes.
know. It is projecting your own inner self or what intentions
yeah.
you have. So what you want to show is what is projected.
True.
So pressure is definitely there, but you need to take it in a very beautiful way, and give a message to everybody that, you know, life is not just this, like, you know, you can achieve much more by you know, representing on this platform. You take it forward in a better way for human development, for human race.
Yes,
that's what I feel.
That's very true. Ujala, I mean, for Ujala, I think it's a tough journey, because she's a working woman and the preparations. So what made you apply, you know, because most of the times people think that pageants means they're going to the modeling,
mm-hmm.
but you're already, you know, into corporate world, you
mm-hmm.
know, you're already, you have well flourished career in corporate. So what made you apply, and how people responded when you applied for it?
Oh, this was the question that was asked to me all the time when I decided to apply for.
So I was the right person to
Mrs. Mrs. India, yes. Karnataka. I think everybody back at my workplace, they asked me, you have a great career here, so why do you want to get into a beauty pageant?
Yeah.
And so I try to convince them, and I actually wanted to prove them wrong, mm-hmm. that it's not just about beauty or your looks. I'm going there to reinvent myself, because I got into self-management some time back, because I think when I was blessed with my baby mm-hmm. 4 years back, I lived with a sense of guilt for quite some time, because I'm a working mother.
Yeah.
And I had to leave him back home and get to work.
Yeah.
And I think that guilt actually was there with me for a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
And then I thought, let me just, you know, kind of reinvent myself and kind of get yes. some sort of a self-assurance and a reassurance that, you know, I can do something, and I can do something different from what I've been doing for so many years.
Yes.
So that was one of the reasons why I entered Mrs.
India. But I think you have lived your motherhood so beautifully. I remember when she was walking on the stage, her son was, you know, shouting, Mama, Mama, and he didn't have, I think, no lunch, no breakfast, and he just wanted to, you know, meet his mother, and she was there. So it wasn't very difficult to walk on the stage, you know, and give your best, you know.
It's always about striking a balance. I know, you know, I was required to be on the stage and walk out there, but again, I know I have a responsibility as a mother.
Yeah.
And I think that's when I took permission and walked off the stage and fed my son and came back and walked again. So I know, I mean, it is kind of tough.
But I think that's the beauty of being mother, right?
That's right.
And that's all about motherhood, you know.
Absolutely.
Like your daughter had supported you.
Absolutely.
That you go ahead and do it, you know. So I think that's all about being beauty of being a mother, you know. The motherhood, it doesn't mean the sacrifice
that's
all the time,
mm-hmm.
right? The sacrifice is, of course, the sacrifices are good for the family, but sometimes, you know, the family also have to come ahead and support them. And I think you all are here because of, you know, your family's thought that you should go ahead and do it, you know. And it's a beautiful feeling all about.
Yes, you get to know who your strength is, actually.
True, true, true. Now, when we speak about the challenges, you know, I always remember of Vaishnavi with her weight loss, because I think that is the one worldwide challenge that everyone is going through. So, from you have lost 55 kgs in 2 years.
55 kgs, and body shaming is something so common nowadays that, you know, you're either too thin, too fat, too fair, too dark for you know people. You can never be enough. So I definitely had certain situations earlier, like in my daughter's school sports day, when I went to participate, and people laughed at me, like, because I couldn't run.
Mm-hmm.
So I couldn't even respond at that point of time. I cried, and then I decided there's no point of crying.
No.
I had to take action and do something about it. So I really worked hard for 2 years with my diet and heavy workout.
But 55 kgs around like 100 pounds, more than 100, 110 points.
Now it's almost 26, 27 months.
Yeah.
So I
but it's a very short period. I think, you know, she's one hero. You really deserve one. Thank
you.
You know, and I think I'm going to take lots of tips from you. You know, because I think for me you're a hero. You know, because I know losing 1 pound is a challenge. You know, like from last 1 year, I'm struggling, you know, to lose few pounds, and you have lost like more than 100 pounds.
No, it's not just about the workout. You need to have a mindset to lose weight.
Yeah.
And you need to work on positive inputs every single day, because you just don't lose weight like that. Because
so did you had any negative people, you know, that overpowered you, you know, when you was overweight?
Yes, yes, definitely. There were very close associates who would tell me, you know, like, you know, your life is just over, like, you know, I'm into business, I trade jute bags and they get exported to European countries.
Mm-hmm.
But apart from that, I didn't have to go this stress management, like, you know, how to manage this personally.
Yeah.
I started taking it very personally, it started affecting me, know, so I had to do something about it, and it never stops. So now I understand, I'm too thin for some people now. So you'll never be enough, you know.
Yeah. So there's either, nothing called a perfect.
Yes, there's no perfection, but you need to be healthy.
Yes.
You need to be healthy in the mind, body and soul. So
true.
That's when you're aligned. And when you're aligned, you're directly aligned with the source. That's what I believe in.
True. Radhika, about your challenges. I mean, of course, your family's support was there. Your daughter was there. But still, you know.
Challenges as in, I mean, yes, of course, because I'm a single parent. So those challenges were there, where to leave my children. And how to handle when I'm there away for 3 days or 5 days. So that was the biggest challenge that I faced.
Yeah.
But my children were very, very supportive, both of them, my son and my daughter. But luckily they are grown up also, so they can take care. But then they have had always a full-time mom around. So suddenly when
you
I
started
was
in, missing. Yours, when we speak about the national costume, you know, you were carrying a little baby girl.
Yes.
And most of the people, they didn't understand what she was trying to say. You know, she was wearing a Haryana costume and there was a baby girl in that. It was so, the message was so sharp, you know, because the Haryana is the one with the
message.
Child ratio, you know, the girl child ratio is too low. That one attire, a very simple attire, you know, that was very striking and I really liked it.
Thank you, ma'am.
You know, carrying a doll and you know, it's not all about being very you know, glittery about the costume. I think. And we were very clear that the national costume should be a message. You know, and because we are so diverse, you know, so many cultures and ethnicity, and that we have seen it already.
Yes.
And what you showed was something, you know, it was like, oh my God, it's there.
Beti bachao, beti bachao.
And so what you think, you know, you continue your work about the baby, the child.
Yes, I'm still continuing. And recently also, like, I've visited a few orphanages and even a foundation, Earth Savior Foundation. So I've been doing some work with them. And
so the same message when you go internationally, you want to carry the same message?
Definitely. I want to carry. And I would also like everyone who's listening here that they should encourage their daughters.
And I think it's not about being a boy or girl.
Yes.
I think it should be about being a human being.
Human being.
Because there should be a balance between both of them. It's not like, you know, only daughters are important and not the boys.
Yes.
So, you know, when we're talking about national costume, you know, we want to know more about national costume of Ujala, because she's going to show the, you know, environment friendly recycling and all that. So, so what, you have anything in mind that what you want to have for your costumes, national costumes?
I'm still thinking about it. So, like you said, that I'm going for planet.
Yes.
And it's more about environmental issues and eco-friendly stuff. So I think what I would be doing is taking all the recycled products and trying to make a costume out of it, a beautiful outfit. I hope that
that's,
you know,
beautiful.
So she's going to walk with a recycled message, you know. It's very important, because nowadays, you know, it's, we have one thing in our mind that only plastic is disastrous. You know, only plastic is that harms the nature, but that's not true. Our costume, the clothing is the second, comes second in a row after plastic, you know, because we, and nowadays we buy so many dresses, we attend so many events, and then it just keep, you know, stacking just one above the other, and it never gets disposed, or it, and that harms the nature that we don't realize.
Okay.
So I really like that idea, you know. So we are going to look forward what costume she's going to wear. And hopefully we will have, you know, more emphasized talk about her costume. Especially, so you, what you have, you know, in how the preparation have started for the internationals.
For me,
so before going to the internationals, I would like to know, after getting the crown, you know, what you guys are doing now. I mean, how it's been your life?
Life's changed actually. Inner confidence, of course, has built, and feeling of responsibility has increased.
Yes,
that you have to. Otherwise, I mean, like, yes, we would do donations and all off and on even before, but now it's like become a more conscious effort.
You're involved in it,
and yes,
and you go out and keep giving the messages to the society.
We do, definitely. And it's taken in a very more you know, like, people take it more positively.
Yes.
It's not that just any other person is talking about, so they take it more seriously and more positively.
So what are your plans? You know, now you're going to be Mrs. India 2018. You have one complete year with you. Mm-hmm. So you have any plans that how you want to take it further from Jala and start it?
Yeah. So like I said, I'm from the corporate background and mm-hmm. I lead the talent acquisition function mm-hmm. for an IT services company.
Correct.
So my main job is to hire people.
Yes.
So what I was trying to do is to conduct a few, you know, a lot of drives which are specifically for women and women who are, you know, who have taken maternity leave and have joined back, who want to join back the industry.
Yeah.
So I'm conducting a lot of gender diversity, especially within hiring.
Wonderful.
And I mean, this is through my job because that's what I've been doing. So
true.
I'm focusing more on
gender
diversity.
And you can make more difference with
that's right.
your 8 hours of
that's right.
everyday job.
Yeah, yeah. And a lot of work I want to do in child education area, mm-hmm. which has always been close to my heart.
And you have done before also.
Yes.
She has already adopted the kids and she does education for her. I mean, that's where the beauty with heart comes from.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, like I said, I was doing it, but again, a lot of passion has come in now because after winning the crown and after getting the title, I think a lot of responsibility that has come in and we feel even more empowered to do a lot more things that we thought of doing earlier, but we were not able to do.
Yes.
So now we are just going all out and trying to do a lot of stuff. Yes. Yeah.
How about you?
So there's extra wings definitely added, you know, to the soul. And with this crown, people, when you just go and reach out to them and when you go with a purpose, it adds on more value.
Yes.
You know, you can do more. And once people start resonating with what you want to do, all you want to do is more.
True.
You want to do more in different fields, like, you know, not just a girl child education or, you know, not just that. There are many women who are so distressed and so depressed and, you know, they don't know what to do with life. They think life just ends after marriage and they're so demotivated. So I've been reaching out to people like that and just trying to motivate them, doing my bit. Because, you know, that's happiness.
True.
When they get empowered, motivated, you know, you feel more accomplished at the end of the day.
True.
So that's what I have been doing and, you know, I wish to do more.
All of you, you know, is the best moment during the pageant, apart from crowning. I know every one of you is going to say crowning, but apart from the crowning, which are the best moment that you, you know, remember or you cherish?
I enjoyed all the activities that we had.
Mm-hmm. The best activity.
The best activity was Silamba.
Oh, yes. She really enjoyed
it. I really enjoyed
that. And I think you should continue learning the
Yes,
Silamba.
I would love to. Yeah. I'm looking for
So we had this session, we had this workshop on Silamba, which is the ancient martial art form in India. In fact, across the world. And we trained them on how to get hands on it.
Mm.
And she really enjoyed it. I remember.
Enjoyed it.
I think she's more of the feminist, you know, like with her Beti Bachao Andolan and the Silamam and all.
Yeah.
So she's going to be the she's going to be the one of the power ladies. So how about you? Which was the
So for me it's been always with Ujala. The journey has begun with Ujala and we've enjoyed and relished each and every
queen
moment.
Sisters.
Yes, queen sisters, absolutely. And I am really grateful for that because there are many moments where you feel low and you know, you just feel very drained out.
Yeah.
Yes. And those were the times when she would encourage me and, you know, she would just push me ahead, like, you know.
Yeah.
And not only that, the workshops, what I learned, you know, when I look back, I have so much of memories to carry, you know, so I'm very grateful for each and every moment spent out there.
Oh, that's nice. But I think Golden Goddess was
the
best.
Yeah, the Golden Goddess was the best one. Thank you so much for that. It was really beautiful. And
there was one photo shoot call. We had different themes of photo shoot. And the one photo shoot theme was Golden Goddess, where they're supposed to come pose as a Golden Goddess. So that was, you know, fun. And I remember you girls were cheering each other. It was like so much of fun with the music and you posing and all. So which was one for you, Shala?
I mean, the feeling is mutual because I also enjoyed every bit of my journey with Vaishnavi, and I enjoyed all throughout my journey at Mrs. India. But the best moment was the dosa making competition.
Oh, yes. I agree. Because I made the best dosa.
I mean, I've been staying in Bangalore for 12 years and I never made dosa at home. And here I make dosa for the first time and mine was one of the best dosas. Wow. I was like, wow.
That's all as experts, right? I mean, they say that the people who are good in one thing, they're good at everything. You know, and dosa making was something, you know, we did not inform you, because if you would have informed you, you have done the practice at home and then you come and deliver the best dosa. So the dosa making was basically not only about the skill of making it, you know, there are so many aspects to it, you know, like some made, you know, they left their marks behind, some made variety in the same one dosa and all that. So it was basically, you know, personality tasting than the dosa making. So yes, so we have like this, there are so many moments that we are going to come, and we're going to have one wonderful year ahead working together at, as I said before, Mrs. India family. And we will come back like more and more charts like this. So thank you very much. Thanks, queens.
Thank you so much.
And looking forward, and I wish all the very best for international pageants.
Thank you so much.
Come home glorious, make India proud, and we all are proud of you.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you.